इन व्यू ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट इलेक्शंस टू द लेजिस्लेचर्स एंड द लोकल रिप्रेजेंटेटिव बॉडीज आर नाउ अ परमानेंट फीचर ऑफ द लाइफ ऑफ द नेशन इट हैज़ बीन बिकम अर्जेंटली नेसेसरी टू पुट द इलेक्शन मशीनरी इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एंड देयर सब डिविजन्स ऑन अ मोर सेटिस्फैक्ट्री एंड वेल थॉट आउट बेसिस इन द कमीशन्स व्यू अ सेपरेट नक्लियस इलेक्शन ऑफिस विद एन एडवोकेट परमानेंट स्टाफ ऑन अ होल टाइम बेसिस should be set up in every district and subdivision and this office should be temporarily strengthened by additional hands at the time of an election. The district or subdivisional election officers may normally be part-time officers who must, however, be relieved of most, if not all, of their other duties at the time of the elections. In the course of inspections of some district election offices undertaken by the Election Commission, it was noticed that the organization at the district and subdivisional level is almost always inadequate and very often haphazard and unsatisfactory. This is not at all fair to the officers who are expected to carry on this important duty, and it is not to be wondered that the work done by the election staff in between two general elections is very often below the requisite standard and comes in for severe criticism. Much more sustained and better organized efforts would be called for in future than hitherto if even such routine work is to be done in an efficient and business-like manner. A permanent and adequate nucleus election office at each administrative center is therefore essential. In regard to the preparation and maintenance of the electoral rolls of a constituency, the permanent machinery consists of the Election Commission, the Chief Electoral Officer, and the Electoral Registration Officer of the constituency. There is an Electoral Registration Officer for each assembly constituency, and it is his responsibility to prepare and annually revise the electoral roll for the constituency as required by law. The law has made provision for the appointment of one or more assistant electoral registration officers to assist the electoral registration officer in the performance of his functions. Every assistant electoral registration officer is subject to the control of the electoral registration officer competent to perform all or any of the functions of the electoral registration officer. The electoral registration officer, who is an officer of the government, is nominated by the Election Commission. The assistant electoral registration officers are also appointed by the Election Commission. Generally, officers of the status of deputy commissioners, collectors, deputy collectors, tahsildars, etc., were appointed as electoral registration officers while officers junior to them were appointed to assist them as assistant electoral registration officers. For each parliamentary constituency, a returning officer is appointed by the election commission. He has to be an officer of government. One or more persons who are also officers of government are appointed as assistant returning officers to assist him in the performance of his functions. Whenever by elections or general elections are to be held, the returning officer comes into action. Subject to the approval of the commission, the returning officer selects the polling stations for his constituency. He also makes all preparatory arrangements for the holding of the poll. He appoints the personnel required for the conduct of the poll. The size of the polling personnel depends on the extent of the constituency and the number of polling stations. The returning officer duty continues until the last candidate has lodged his account of election expenses. The assistant returning officers were originally debarred from performing any of the prescribed functions of the returning officer which related to the counting of votes unless the latter was unavoidably prevented from performing such functions. In a large constituency, it sometimes becomes necessary to count votes at different places. As the assistant returning officers were not permitted to do this, the returning officer himself had to count votes at all such places one after another. This often resulted in a good deal of avoidable delay. Under the amended law, the assistant returning officers are now eligible to undertake the counting of votes subject to the overall control of the returning officer. The only function of the returning officer which an assistant returning officer is not competent to perform at present is the scrutiny of nomination papers. Even this he is permitted to undertake if the returning officer is unavoidably prevented from holding such scrutiny himself. There were certain former Indian states which had entered into an agreement with them, British India, about the execution of decrees passed in the territories of either of them. There was no difficulty about that. With respect to the decision of the Mumbai High Court, I find that there were more than 200 states in that small part known as Saurashtra, and there were other states also in Gujarat. There were some states like Kolhapur and others in Maharashtra. In respect of many of these states, probably I think there were agreements between the British India and these states.